Yay, you made it through another week of poi lessons, and I made you run around and dance this time around, so that actually is something you should feel very, very proud about this week. So, this week we are also working with a new combo that is going to put together a lot of the different elements that we've been playing with over the course of the past couple weeks. So, let's check that out. Drex here from DrexFactor.com, helping to bring the love of poi spinning and flow arts into your world. And today we are going to be learning a piece of poi choreography that is going to bring together everything that we've been learning in the past month and hopefully help you see some of the links between all these things, yeah? Before we dive in, I just want to give a quick shout out to the friends of the channel. Big thanks to Dark Monk, Flow Toys, Pyroterra Light Toys, LMF Props, Spin Balls, and Ultra Poi for helping to make the videos on this channel possible. You can learn more about all these awesome companies and the work that they're doing to support flow artists like yourself by checking out the links that I've got down in the description of this video. Goodness. So I have been recording all of this week's videos back to back, which is very, very helpful for being able to edit them and getting them out on time and everything and not drive myself crazy doing so. It is not so good for me being able to hold on to my voice for an entire day, though. So I apologize if I'm a little bit froggy through this one. So clearly, I really, really love poi dance, and I've very deliberately been putting moves out there over the course of the past month that I think are conducive to making poi dance happen. So I am really hoping that this connects some dots for some of y'all out there, because we haven't gotten to a lot of really common poi tricks, like, you know, corkscrews and weaves and everything. We're gonna get there, don't worry. But I did want to show everybody just that there's plenty of potential for moving with the poi without having to get into those tricks, which I sometimes think are unusually or like unnecessarily difficult for people just starting out. So to get down this week's combo, you are going to need to be able to do your shanai turns with the poi going in both together same as well as together opposites. You're also going to need to be able to do your pendulums and tuck turns in together same. You're going to need to remember your in-spin flowers. And of course, you are going to need to have your stalls under your belt, yeah? So, let's dive in and see what that looks like. And of course, I will leave links to the tutorials for all these down in the description. So one of the keys to this combo is that almost all the tricks in it come in twos. And I'm really just doing that to help you maintain count of them. If you want to do all these tricks in fours instead, I'm 100% okay with that. I just want to make sure that it's consistent because I want to make sure that y'all out there are practicing these tricks in such a way that you are getting control over exactly how many repetitions you can do of each of them, right? So we start off with tuck turns and we think that we go under, over, under, over. So it's twice that we go through the over spot, thinking once, twice, and from there, that moment when the poi head out to our right hand side, we're going to drop them into pendulums going together same. And as that happens, I actually want you to like feel that go through your entire body. Give me a little bit of a plie with your knees as you're going down and everything, right? So again, we think under, over, under, over, and plie down and around for the pendulum once and twice. And as we come around the second time with the pendulums, this is when we're going to switch into extensions. But we're going to do them in such a way that we're doing our shanai step over to the side here, yeah? So that shanai step is going to be stepping forward on the right, back on the left, yeah? Aren't you glad that you learned it going both directions? Think that the step starts when the poi are coming down and around. So they kind of drag the right foot around and then the left foot goes back, yeah? In order to do this, you're going to have to pick up some momentum off of that second pendulum. So as it comes around for the second time, think that you're almost like jumping into it, you know? This really should be a thing that like feels like the dynamics and the energy of it are picking up just slightly there. So we did the shanai step, and it was beautiful. And as the poi come around in that last extension, I want you to just stall them both over to your right-hand side here, yeah? Think of it as being that you're going to continue the momentum around and then stop. So there's like one more beat of an extension that happens directly in front of you in wall plane before they come around to a stall. So think that you're trying to kill the momentum of them as they're going around that last time in front of you, yeah? Think that you're picking up the energy and taking it back down. Yeah? Okay, so from here, you're going to stall your left hand out, and now we're going to bring the poi up and around into our thread the needles, thinking once, twice, and then do another plie as we do these in-spin flowers right here. So really, when you're going from the thread the needle right here and everything, all you're doing is like letting your arms go further out to the sides each time. And of course, coming around to arms crossed and open, arms crossed and open. If you just want to give me petals out to the side and forget about the middle part, that's perfectly fine too. I just want to see a dynamic shift from that thread the needle to going out and around, yeah? If you can do the petals as your arms are crossed though, oh boy howdy, I do want to see that. I totally just touched my face in between takes there. Darn. All right, so we're doing our in-spin flowers, and I want you to be counting out that second time that your poi are going out to the sides. You're going to switch into together opposites and come around and do a shunné step going back to the right. So think that it can come right after the flower petal. Think that they go up past your ears, down past your hips, and then they come to a rest down in front of you. So it's almost like you're going to do another flower petal and then decide against it as they come down. The whole thing is going to look like this. Basically, you do the thread the needle once, twice, and once out to the side, twice out to the side, and then we take it all the way around and drop them down. Yeah? So let's see the whole combo from the beginning. So we had tuck turns going under, over, under, over, and pendulums around, pendulums around, and we take that step and stall. Bring the left hand out and thread the needle once, twice, and around big, twice, and we take it all the way around to stop. Yeah? All right, let's see that again in slow-mo. Did you get it? I want to see it. Make sure that you post a video of yourself doing this combo to Facebook or Instagram. I am DrexFactor on Instagram and DrexFactorPoi on Facebook. Make sure that you tag me so I can see this stuff. For the most part, I've been pretty good about checking out people's videos and like leaving them feedback and everything, and I would love to see yours too. Pretty please remember to like, share, and subscribe. Help me get these videos out to the wider world so we have more Flowmies to play with when this whole thing is blown over, which yes, I believe that time will come. And all this time that people are spending indoors and everything, I think is time that they can be using to like be able to catch up on these skills and everything and be able to learn them for the first time. So I would love to see that happen, and I hope you would as well. If you are getting anything out of these videos and if you would like to see them continue, pretty please consider signing up to support this work on Patreon, like all these nice folks did. Patreon is what is keeping me afloat through this crisis. It is what is making sure that I can still pay rent and buy groceries and everything. And that honestly means the world to me right now. These are very, very uncertain times, and I have a lot of friends that are certainly in a bad place and, you know, looking for whatever opportunities they can get. So I'm very, very grateful that I have this. If you are interested in doing this, and if you don't have the means, no pressure, but if you would, you can head on over to patreon.com/drexfactorpoi and sign up. You get early access to all of my content, as well as be able to vote in topics that I tackle in the future. And of course, every once in a while, I will do some behind the scenes stuff there too. So yeah, you should check it out if you've got the ability to. Goodness. Okay, so I promise next week is going to be less dance heavy. We're going to go back to some more traditional poi tricks for y'all and everything. I just wanted to get people moving their feet while I could, and while the knowledge from timing and direction stuff and everything was still kind of fresh. So next week, we will be diving into some more poi tricks that are easily done inside. And yes, finally, I will be teaching the 3-beat weave. So tune in for that. I'll see you next week. Peace.